Welcome to this NPTEL Lectures on Robotics, Basic and Advanced Concepts. In the last lecture, we had looked at the serial manipulator Jacobian matrix. Okay, so we started with the propagation of linear and angular velocity vectors. Then we reorganized these angular velocity vectors into something into the joint rates. And then we equated that to the linear and angular velocity of the end effector. Okay, so we could start from zero, which is the fixed coordinate system, propagate upwards to link one, link two, and so on. Okay, in this lecture, we'll look at parallel manipulator Jacobian matrix. So in the parallel manipulator Jacobian matrix, we do not have a single way of going from the fixed to the chosen end effector. There are multiple paths, there are multiple loops. So we need to look at how to obtain the parallel manipulator Jacobian matrix. Okay, so in a parallel manipulator, it has both actuated and passive joints. So the configuration vector or configuration space vector Q contains both theta and phi, and we have been using theta to denote the actuated joints and phi to denote the passive joints. The loop closure equations do not contain all the joint variables. So for example, we had looked at this 3RPS parallel robot, and when we broke up at the spherical joint, then it did not contain the joint variables of the spherical joint. The other important thing is there is no natural choice of end effector. So hence, we cannot do velocity propagation. So we do not know which one is the end effector and where to start from and where to end. Okay, in a platform type parallel manipulator, like the Stewart platform or the 3RPS manipulator, the position of centroid and orientation of the platform is of interest most of the time. Okay, so how do we find the linear and angular velocity of the centroid of the top platform and the orientation of the top platform? Okay, so given the orientation of the top platform, and if you choose that the centroid is the point of interest, the angular velocity of the top platform or the coordinate system can be obtained by R dot R transpose. Okay, so remember, I had shown you that in general, the space fixed angular velocity vector can be obtained as R dot R transpose. So that is what is shown here. And we can rearrange this expression once we have obtained the space fixed angular velocity vector into a matrix times Q dot. So now note that there will be both theta dot and phi dot, because the position vector or the rotation matrix of the platform or the tool coordinate system will contain both theta and phi. Likewise, the linear velocity of the centroid of the top platform can be obtained as, in this case, the sum of the linear velocity of the three connection points. Okay, so in the 3RPS case, we had three connection points, three spherical joints, and we can obtain the velocity of the centroid as a mean of all these three velocity vectors. Okay, with respect to zero coordinate system. For a Stewart platform with many other connection points, again, we can obtain similar angular velocity and linear velocity vectors. So this matrix J omega Q, which is a function of Q, and JVQ are the angular and linear velocity Jacobian matrices. Okay, and Q dot is the time derivative of the configuration variable Q. So the linear and angular velocity vectors are function of all Q and Q dot. Okay, however, in a parallel manipulator, only the actuated joints theta or I, assume there are n of them, are specified. The M passive joints can be obtained from direct kinematics. Okay, we also need expressions for the phi dots, the rate of change of the passive joint variables, okay, and obtain linear and angular velocity in terms of only theta dot, okay, because theta dots are the ones where there are motors, we know what is the actuated joint rates, so we should be able to find the linear and angular velocity of the chosen output link in terms of only the actuated joint variables. Okay, so basically we need to find phi dot in terms of theta dots. And how do we do that? We can obtain this from the loop closure constraint equations. Okay, so let's start. So for the m passive variables, we have m constraint equations eta I q1 through qn plus m equal to zero. Okay, so this is a general form, but basically there are m constraint equations, which is of the form n of eta of q equal to zero. So it's a vector equation. So we can differentiate this equation with respect to time. Okay, so when we differentiate with respect to time, we'll have theta dot and phi dot. And then we can reorganize all terms containing theta dot in a matrix, which I'm going to call K. Okay, so K is a function of all the configuration variables. Likewise, I reorganize the terms containing phi dot into a matrix, which is K star. Okay, so we can always do this. Why? Because when we take the derivative of this constraint equations, we can only get theta dot and phi dot. We will not get any other nonlinear terms in theta dot and phi dot. Okay, so the columns of this M cross N matrix KQ are basically nothing but the partial derivatives of this eta of Q with respect to the actuated joint variables. Okay, so just by chain rule. So d eta by d theta into theta dot will be this term, okay, in a matrix form. Likewise, K star Q, which is M by M matrix, why? Because these are M constraint equations, okay? And we take the partial derivatives of eta of Q with respect to the passive variables phi, which are M of them. Thetas are N of them. So this K is an M cross N matrix, whereas K star is always a M cross M matrix. It's a square matrix. Okay, so that is what I'm mentioning again. K star Q is always a M cross M square matrix. Okay, and K matrix and the K star matrix are functions of both theta and phi. Okay, let's continue. So if determinant of K star is not equal to zero, then I can solve for phi dot, which is minus K star inverse K into theta dot. Okay, so you can see that this is a linear equation. If determinant of K star is not equal to zero, can we take the determinant of K star? Yes, it's a square matrix. So phi dot will be equal to minus K star inverse into theta dot, which is what is written here. Now we can go back to the angular velocity expression, which is omega 0 omega tool, and partition it into two parts. One is j omega into theta dot, and then j star omega into phi dot. We can always do this because the linear and angular velocity vectors are always linearly related to theta dot and phi dot. Okay, similarly, the linear velocity of the tool, okay, a chosen point on the platform, okay, or on the chosen output link, can be written in terms of jv into theta dot plus j star v into phi dot. Okay, once we have this, we can substitute phi dot in these two equations. Okay, so if I substitute phi dot in the first equation, we will get the angular velocity of the tool is j omega minus j omega star k star inverse k theta dot. Okay, so you can see this phi dot will become minus k star inverse k theta dot, and then we can take all of this together and we'll have j omega minus this. Likewise, the linear velocity of the tool will be jv minus jv star k star inverse k into theta dot. Okay, so we can now define an equivalent Jacobian matrix for the angular velocity for the parallel robot. So j omega equivalent and likewise a jv equivalent, as jv equivalent is jv minus j star v k star inverse k. Okay, j omega equivalent is j omega minus j omega star k star inverse k. Okay, so it's fairly straightforward. So all I have done is, if determinant of k star is not equal to zero, I have solved for phi dot and substituted back into the expressions for the linear and angular velocity vector, and then reorganize them. Now with JV equivalent and J omega equivalent, we can write the equivalent Jacobian in this form. So we have on the left hand side the linear velocity of the tool and the angular velocity of the tool. They are separated by this dash. So remember, this has meters per second and this has radians per second. These are different units. And we can write together 0 to J equivalent into theta dot. Okay, so what is J equivalent? The 6 by n matrix here will contain the first 3 into n rows are from JV equivalent, and the next 3 into n rows are from J omega equivalent. Again, okay, so this is the matrix which is the parallel manipulator Jacobian matrix. Okay, so like in serial manipulators, it is not a true Jacobian matrix in the sense that it is not derived from the derivative of a vector valued function. Okay, it contains the top half contains units of meter, the bottom half contains unitless. Okay, so at a known Q, we can solve or we can relate the theta dots with the linear and angular velocity of the tool. Okay, so if I know what is Q, this J equivalent is a function of Q of the configuration. At every configuration, this J equivalent will be different. If I give you theta dot, you can multiply this J equivalent to theta dot and obtain the linear and angular velocity of the tool. Okay, very similar to the serial manipulator Jacobian matrix, except now that we have taken some effort to eliminate the passive joint rates and obtain an equivalent Jacobian in terms of only the actuated joint rates. Okay, so like serial robots, okay, or serial manipulators, this JV equivalent can be also be used to define a GV equivalent for parallel manipulators. So remember, we have during the geometric interpretation of the Jacobian matrix, we have taken J transpose J, and then we had found the eigenvalues of the equivalent J transpose J. So in this case, we have to find the GV equivalent, which is JV minus JV star K inverse K, transpose the whole thing. Okay, so this GV equivalent is symmetric and positive definite. Okay, it is symmetric because it is like A transpose A. And similar to serial manipulator, the tip of the linear velocity vector lies on an ellipse or an ellipsoid. So if it is moving in a plane, it lies on the ellipse. If platform is moving in 3D space, the linear velocity vector tip traces an ellipsoid. However, as you can see, this is so much more complicated. It is not simply JV transpose JV. Okay, we have all these JV star, K star inverse, K. So it also contains the loop closure constraint equations and the effect of the loop closure constraint equations, because we have taken derivatives of those and obtained K and K star matrices. Okay, we can also find G omega equivalent, again using J omega equivalent, and again the angular velocity can be described as an ellipse. The tip of the angular velocity vector traces an ellipse or an ellipsoid. So all this is happening only if and only if determinant of K star not equal to zero. So if determinant of K star were equal to zero, then we could not solve phi dot because it has K star inverse. Okay. So let's take an example. So again, we will take the simplest possible example, which is the planar four-bar mechanism. So we break this four-bar mechanism at this third joint. So we will get one planar 2R and a single 1R manipulator. So in the planar 2R, we have theta 1 and phi 2, these two angles, and L1 and L2, whereas the 1R will have phi 1 and L3. Okay, these are the main important things. So the constraint equation of the four bar for breaking at the third joint, we have seen this earlier. It is L1 cos theta 1 plus L2 cos theta 1 plus phi 2 minus L0 minus L3 cos phi 1 equal to 0. Okay, so this is the x component. Similarly, the y component is L1 sin theta 1 plus L2 sin theta 1 plus phi 2 minus L3 sin phi 1 equal to 0. Okay, so in these two constraint equations, theta 1 is the actuated joint variable and phi 1 and phi 2 are the passive joint variables. So we can take the derivative of these two equations with respect to time and then take all terms containing theta 1 dot and all terms containing phi 1 dot and phi 2 dot and write it in this form. So the first term is a column vector, which is minus L1 sin theta 1 minus L2 sin theta 1 plus phi 2, L1 cos theta 1 plus L2 cos theta 1 plus phi 2. When you take the derivative, you'll get these terms into theta 1 dot. And then the next term, so this is the K matrix. So this is K into theta dot, theta 1 dot. Then we can also find the derivative with K star matrix and rearrange the derivatives. And then we can write L3 sin phi 1 minus L2 sin theta 1 plus phi 2. Okay. And the second row is minus L3 cos phi 1 and L2 cos theta 1 plus phi 2 and multiplying phi 1 dot and phi 2 dot. So this is the K star matrix. So this is K into theta dot plus K star into phi dot is equal to 0. So the K star matrix, K and K star matrix for the planar 4 bar are, so K is a column vector actually, and K star is a 2 by 2 matrix. So the as expected, the K and K star matrices are functions of both the actuated joint variables, which is theta 1, and the passive joint variables with this phi 1 and phi 2. So phi 1 doesn't appear in K, but it does appear in K star. Okay. So as you can see, it is very, very easy to calculate for a planar 4 bar. For multi-degree of freedom spatial mechanisms, this is not so easy to do, okay, because the loop closure equations will be much more complex, and then we have to take the derivatives, and then we have to organize each one of these into something into theta dot and something into phi dot. So it requires a lot of effort. But we can use a symbolic algebra software such as Maple to do this. Okay. And in fact, I will show you examples later where we have used this symbolic software package called Maple. Okay. And then derive the K and K star matrices. Okay. So let's take another example, which is a spatial 3-degree of freedom manipulator. So this is that well-known 3-RPS manipulator, which we have looked at earlier. So there is a fixed base, there is a moving platform. Then each point in the top platform is connected to the point in the fixed base by a RPS. Okay. So R rotation is theta, actuated joint variable is L, and S is the spherical joint, which since we are going to break it at the spherical joints, the angles at the spherical joints do not appear. So there are three actuated joints, L1, L2, L3, and there are three passive joints, theta 1, theta 2, theta 3. So as I said, we break at the spherical joint, then we obtain the position vector of S1, which is spherical joint 1, S2, and S3, with respect to the fixed coordinate system, which is at the centroid of the bottom platform. Okay, and the point which is of interest, the output link is the moving platform, and the point of interest or the velocity, linear velocity, which we will calculate, is for the centroid of the top platform, which is Px, Y, Z. Okay. How do I find the loop closure equations? As I have shown you earlier, we find these vectors with respect to 0, and then 0 to S1, 0 to S2, 0 to S3. Okay, and then we show that the distance between S1 and S2 is constant, distance between S1 and S3 is constant, and between S2 and S3 is constant. So we use the SS pair constraint equations. So for the 3-RPS manipulator, the three constraint equations are, first equation is 3 minus 3a squared L1 squared plus L2 squared L1 and 2 C1 C2 and so on. Okay, so here L1 and L2 are the actuations at the two prismatic joints, first and second prismatic joint. A is one of the sides of the top platform. P is taken to be 1, very similar to what we have done earlier. And C1 means cos theta 1. Okay, S1 means sine theta 1. The second equation is the distance between 2 and 3. Okay, so it contains theta 2 and theta 3 and L2 and L3, points spherical joint S2 and S3. The third equation is the distance between spherical joint S3 and spherical joint S1 is constant. Okay, and hence we get another equation. So they all look similar, except the angles are different slightly. So we can again take the derivatives of these three constraint equations with respect to time and rearrange to find K and K star matrix. Okay, so K will involve the derivatives with respect to the actuated joint variables L1, L2, L3. Okay, so you can see that if I take the derivative of the first equation with L1, I will get one term like this. So it is 2L1 minus 3C1 from here, and then L2C1, C2, L2, C1, C2, and minus 2L2, S1, S2 from here. Second term is derivative with respect to theta L2. So we can again this term. There is no L3 appearing in this first equation, so that term will be 0. Okay. Likewise, in the second row, L1 doesn't appear. So when you take the derivative of the second equation with respect to L1, partial derivative, it will be 0, something, and something. And the third row will be, again, there is L1 appearing, so partial derivatives, there will be a term. And you can see it will be 2L1. And then L3, C3, C1, L3, C3, C1, and so on. Okay, and you can just by inspection see that this is the K matrix. The K star matrix involves partial derivatives with respect to the joint variables. In this case, the passive joint variables are theta. Okay, so we have to take derivatives of this with respect to theta 1. So derivative of C1 will become sine theta 1 and so on. So this part will not be there. Okay. So you can see that the partial derivative of the first equation with respect to theta 1 will be this term with respect to theta 2. In the second term is with respect to theta 2. Okay, theta 2 is also here. There is no theta 3 occurring in this equation. Okay. So the term will be 0. Likewise, there is no theta 1 occurring in the second equation because it is the distance between the second and the third spherical joint. And in the third equation, one more term will be 0. Okay, so for the centroid, JV and JV star are given by this. We can find out that it is 1 by 3 minus C1, 1 by 2 C2, 1 by 2 C3, and so on. And JV star can also be computed. So JV star corresponding to the J corresponding to the passive joint variables. Okay, so we have K, we have K star, we have JV, and we have JV star. Okay, to obtain J omega and J omega star, we have to take the R dot R transpose first. Okay, and then rearrange. So we have to find the angular velocity vector using R dot R transpose, then rearrange it into something into L dot and something into theta dot. L dot is the actuated joint variable. So it will be J omega into L dot and J omega star into theta dot. So these expressions are very large. As you can see, the rotation matrix, derivative, then post-multiplying with the transpose, it will become too much. Okay, so we have done this using MAPLE, but for simplifying the task of MAPLE, we have taken L1 as 2 by 3, L2 as 3 by 5, and L3 is 3 by 4. Okay, and the corresponding L1, for this L1, L2, L3, we can find theta 1, theta 2, theta 3 using the direct kinematics of this 3R manipulator, 3RPS manipulator. Okay, which we have done earlier. Okay, remember we get a 8th degree polynomial and so on. And substituting this L1, L2, L3 and theta 1, theta 2, theta 3 in this r dot r transpose and simplifying, we will get j omega as a 3x3 matrix. Okay, so these are terms. And j omega star is another 3x3 matrix. Likewise, for this set of L1, L2, L3, and theta 1, theta 2, theta 3, we can also find JV equivalent and J omega equivalent. Okay, so what was J omega equivalent? J omega plus minus K into K star inverse, all those things. Complicated expression for the equivalent Jacobian matrix. Likewise, we can find JV equivalent. Okay, and for A equals half, L1, L2, L3 is equal to 0.5, 1.0 and 2.0 meters. We can solve for theta 1, theta 2, theta 3. We will get this by direct kinematics. Okay, so I am picking a point, and then at that point, I want to draw the tip of the linear velocity vector. Okay, so this is a motion in 3D. So we expect that the tip of the linear velocity vector traces a ellipsoid. Okay, so I'm going to show you the picture of this ellipsoid obtained numerically. And the maximum, intermediate, and minimum velocities along the principal axis of the ellipsoid are, again, we can compute because they are the square root of the eigenvalues of the equivalent Jacobian matrix. Okay, so 0.3724, 3162, 02031 meters per second. And the direction of the principal axis also we can find out. How is the ellipsoid located in 3D space with respect to the zero coordinate? We'll get these vectors. Okay, so this is what is shown in this picture. So this view is a 3D view, 3D plot in MATLAB. So it shows you that this is Vx, Vy, Vz. So from 0, 0, 0, which is the center here, the tip traces this ellipsoid. We can also look at the sectional views. We can see what is happening in the ZY plane or the ZX plane or the XY plane. And you can see all of them are ellipses, which is what is expected. So if you look at an ellipsoid in these sections, we'll get ellipses. So in summary, the parallel manipulator Jacobian in terms of active and passive joint variables, we can derive two more matrices K and K star occur. Okay, so these come from the derivative of the constraint equations. We can solve for the passive joints rates phi I dot in terms of the actuated joint rates and then obtain an equivalent Jacobian. So we can substitute phi dot into the Jacobian matrix. Okay, it will be sub j omega theta dot plus j omega star phi dot. We substitute phi dot and get an equivalent j omega equivalent. Okay, we can obtain this equivalent Jacobian only if determinant of k star is equal to zero. Why? Because otherwise we cannot solve for phi dot. And we can obtain a geometric interpretation as in the case of the serial manipulator. So we can show that the tip of the centroid or tip of the point chosen on the output link traces an ellipse if it is in moving in a plane and or if it's an ellipsoid. So the 3RPS, it traced an ellipsoid. Okay, so it is clearly much more difficult than serial manipulators, right? Because there are several problems. We had to eliminate the passive variables. We had to find a point where for actuated joint variables, what were the passive joint variables? We also have to compute this K star inverse, K and JV star and J omega star. It's a many, many terms are there. Okay. But it can be done numerically, as I've shown you in these two examples. So with this, we'll stop this lecture. In the next lecture, we'll look at the singularities in serial and parallel manipulators.